is the first case in which a suspected war criminal has been brought to trial in Japan for an offense which he committed against American prisoners of war. The conduct of war among civilized nations is regulated by certain well-established rules known as the rules or laws of war. Many of these laws have been set forth in treaties or conventions to which the United States and other nations are parties. These are commonly known as the written laws of war. Some of the laws of war have never been incorporated in any treaty or convention to which the United States.
Was Tsuchiya's conduct towards citizens of will you describe this building to the commission? Ask him to answer my question as I ask you. Do you remember that any of your visits in the hospital during the month of March, whether you saw an American prisoner of war who had been badly beaten and bruised in the same year, March 43?
So what you have been in law? 3月のうちに病院を点検しているときに不良で打撲傷を受けておった人を見ましたか？
いません。
I did not see this person.
United States of America versus Tatsuo Tsuchiya. For emphasis, Tsuchiya, T-S-U-T-C-H-I-A, T-A-C-I-A, T-E-C-H-I-C-I-A, S-A-N. Charge, and between November 1942 and November 1944, at Tokyo area, number 2 detached prisoner of war camp, Mitsushima, Honshu, Japan, also known as Mitsushima camp, number 12 branch camp, and number 3 detached camp. Tatsuo Tsuchiya. Tsuchiya Tatsuo Tahisha-san, then a guard serving with the armed forces of Japan, a nation at war with the United States of America and its allies, did willfully and unlawfully commit cruel, inhuman, and brutal atrocities and other offenses against certain prisoners of war held in captivity at the aforesaid camp, all in violation of the laws and customs of war. One, that on or about 5 March 1943, at Tokyo area, number 2 detached prisoner of war camp, Mitsushima, Honshu, Japan, variously known as Mitsushima camp, number 12 branch camp, and number 3 detached camp, Tatsuo Tsuchiya, also known as Tsuchiya, Tatsuya, Tahisha-san, and Mubasa-san, then a guard serving with the armed forces of Japan, in conjunction with Corporal Kanichi Yoshizawa, also known as Mushman, Tamatsu Kimura, also known as Punk. Kiwata, first name unknown. Also known as Kiwata and River Two. Fujimoto, first name unknown. Also known as Speedo. A Japanese guard known as Big Fly-san. A Japanese medical orderly known as Shonin. And a Japanese interpreter known as Mickey Mouse. Did willfully and unlawfully, unmercifully, beat and kill Private First Class Robert Gordon Tease, variously known as T-E-A-S-E and T-E-I-S, an American prisoner of war held captive by the Japanese armed forces, by brutally and atrociously beating him with knotted ropes and clubs, thereby resulting in his death.
Of charge. Specification number 7 involves an alleged abuse and mistreatment of American and British prisoners of war by forcing them to form two ranks, then face and slap each other until permitted by the accused to stop such slapping. The specification names numerous occasions, I quote, there are numerous occasions between September 1943 and September 1945. I am not guilty to each and all of the specifications. You swear that in accordance with your conscience that you will tell the truth, you will hide nothing, and you will add nothing.
Did you ever sight a prisoner of war by striking him with the side of the palm?
Tins of Red Cross food. The matter was reported to me, and I questioned Tease, who said he had taken the cans from a shed where he had seen them being hidden by a Japanese reservist employed in the camp. I do not think Tease is mad. On arrival at the sick bay, I was astonished to find and Yoshizawa and Tsuchiya made no mention of the Red Cross cans, but accused Tease of having stolen a Japanese shirt. They searched his kit, but found no stolen shirt. In order to make him confess to the theft, Yoshizawa ordered him to stand up on his bunk, and Tsuchiya slashed him repeatedly across the face with a knotted rope, while Yoshizawa jabbed him several times in the stomach with a stick. Strongly Blanchard protested vigorously against this treatment, and after several minutes, the punishment stopped without any confession having been obtained. Keyes was then ordered to stand outside in his underwear. The weather was bitterly cold. I went to Yoshizawa and asked that Keyes be allowed to return to bed. This he was allowed to do after 1 hour and a half. I learned later that Yoshizawa ordered that Keyes was not to be given any food before meals and was obliged to fast from his morning meal until the evening meal of the following day. Keyes died on March 5th, 1943. I am convinced that his treatment, that his death was caused, or at least hastened, by the above described maltreatment. Signed, David Grant, Squadron Leader, RAF. Witness, W.T. Blanchard, Squadron Leader, RAF. Before I discuss the law and facts of this case, I would like to express to the Commission the appreciation of the prosecution of the manner in which the Commission has cooperated and assisted the prosecution in presenting this case to trial. It has been rather difficult for the prosecution to bring before this commission all of the evidence and to present it in a manner that was proper and legal in view of the fact that this was the first time in the history of our military jurisprudence that a case of this nature was being tried before a military commission. My argument to this commission, I wish to call to the attention of the commission a few questions of law that may be of assistance in helping to determine what the problems are in deciding the case of a war criminal and also in deciding the facts that are involved in this case. The general against this accused is that he committed brutal atrocities and other offenses against certain prisoners of war. We have alleged in the specifications that he first, with six other guards and other employees at this prisoner of war camp of Mitsushima, brutally and unmercifully beat and killed on or about March the 5th of 1943, an American prisoner of war by the name of Private Robert Keyes. 1943, he went to discuss the matter about Keyes. He went to Yoshizawa and told him that Keyes was a kleptomaniac. And he asked him to see to it that some hospital treatment should be given to Keyes. And he thought it would be taken care of. But when he came back, he found to his surprise that Yoshizawa and this accused, of course the name is spelt with an S, Tsuchiya, but he also refers to him as being one of the supply men. Cold, frigid air. Gentlemen, I say that there is no question but that Tsuchiya was there, and he was the person, or one of the principals, who trying to exterminate this privateers. Now this was one of the times that he had an occasion to beat him to such an extent that later on these died from the injury. One of the specifications and on the charge of violating the rules of land warfare. And in view of the fact that this accused has committed such atrocious crimes, in view of the fact that this American prisoner of war, who when he surrendered and was captured at Bataan in April of 1942, and thought that he was entitled to the rights of a prisoner of war as guaranteed to him by the Geneva Convention, he surrendered, if he had had an idea in his mind that he would be mistreated in such a manner, you can rest assured that he would never have surrendered, but would have died on the battlefield fighting for his life. But here we have an accused who took advantage of a defenseless prisoner of war, a person who could not protect himself in any way, persecuted, beaten, and tortured, until finally death came as the only relief to his agony and suffering. To impose upon this accused the penalty which I read to you a few moments ago, the penalty of death for the crime which he committed.
The First Marines and Second Army officers, we are here on an assigned task. This accused as to the charge that is made against him. Mr. Keenan has said, and I believe he is the gentleman who is going to prosecute class one criminals, and therefore should more or less set the precedent and the policy for the trial of all types of war criminals. He said when he first came out here, three weeks ago, I remember from the Stars and Stripes that these war criminals were going to be given a fair trial according to the principles of American justice. We are not bound by any of the procedure or any of the rules of evidence, or Anglo-Saxon or any other law. But gentlemen, that is all that you and I know. That is all that you and I have been brought up by and with. What are those principles and what are those concepts? First is that justice shall be meted out to every man. Now what have we got here? It reminds me of the story of the little boys. We used to say, well, come on, let's play marbles. But if you play, you know, if you want to play, you got to play my way. Now what is my way? First to determine, I speak from the prosecution angle, whether or not a war atrocity has been committed. So in order to do that, and I talked to the prosecutor yesterday, we take statements from liberated prisoners of war. Five or six Japanese are charged with him. They could bring in some of those same accused and tell them to describe what he did. No, they prefer to take affidavits. I'm not saying that the American boys who gave those affidavits atrocities, the word deaths occurred, and things of that nature, but I think, in all fairness, that they should be brought here to testify, or this man taken to America to be tried. We don't want witch hunts. We want to find the person who is guilty of war crimes, and when we prove him guilty, according to what we, the American people, the English people, the Anglo-Saxon idea of right and wrong and sense of justice and fair trial is, then we want to punish him firmly. That, gentlemen, is your decision. Hang a man on affidavits or statements is on your conscience. The defense has done the best it can to try to keep this case within what we, as lawyers know, is a fair trial.
Tatsuo Tsuchiya, the commission in closed session finds you. Of specification three of the charge, not guilty. Specification 5 of the charge, not guilty. Specification 6 of charge, not guilty. The commission again, in closed session, and upon secret written ballot, concurring in each finding of guilty, finds you of specification one of the charge, guilty. Of specification two of the charge, guilty. Specification 7 of the charge, guilty. Of the charge, guilty. And again, in closed session and upon secret written ballot, two-thirds of the members present at the time the vote was taken. Concurring, sentence you to be confined at hard labor. Such place as the reviewing authority may direct. For the term of your natural life. Notified the Board of Commission, the Commission will adjourn. and meet at 1330 this afternoon.